doing?
Me? Nothing.
What are you doing in my house? And what's that in your hand?
No, I have to have that money.
No, it's my money and I need it.
I know. But you see, I am Robin Hoodwink.
Don't you mean Robin Hood? And if you are Robin Hood, you're stealing from the wrong person. I am poor.
I know. That's because I am Robin Hoodwink, not Robin Hood. I steal from the poor and give to the rich.
That's the exact opposite of what you should be doing. The poor have nothing and the rich have everything.
Yes, and if I take the money from the poor and give it to the rich, then the rich will finance my campaign for office. Ha 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 ha. My campaign manager, Jim, tells me I got that wrong. If I give the money to the rich will hire more people, pay them higher salaries, and give more to charities.
What charities?
Oh, you know, NFL.
I have no interest in giving to politics, especially the Republican Party.
Ha! Well, you wouldn't be giving to politics, the rich people would.
Yes, with my money. Now, give me my money back before I call the police.
Ha! Call the police. I'm the one who pays their salaries. They won't turn on me.
You may decide how much they make, but I pay their salaries.
That doesn't make sense.
Never mind. Just give me my money back. Now.
Here, take it.
Wait. You took my Social Security card? Why?
Oh, you won't be needing it. I intend to privatize Social Security.
What are you going to get it through your head that you have to watch what you say? You can't say privatize. The people didn't like it when Bush said that. The current terminology is to turn it into a voucher system.
The American people are never going to let you do that. Now, give me my Social Security card.
Fine. Here.
And my EBT card?
Oh, there's no way I'm giving you that. From now on, you have to work for a living.
I do work.
Then work harder. Work more hours. Sorry. No more free ride.
Give me my EBT card immediately. Remember, Fox News says that all poor people are no goods who commit violent crimes. So, you never know what I might do to you. Give it to me!
All right, but you have to agree to vote for me first.
After what you just did, you think I'm going to vote for you?
Come on! Come on! A vote for Robin is a vote for the economy!
No, a vote for Robin is a vote for a thief!
Here, have it. Come on, Jim, let's go next door.
Yes, according to the polls, the next door neighbor is an undecided voter. He'll give you a fair hearing. Women just don't understand the economy. Let's go.
Well, I guess I better go get groceries. Wait a minute. He took my bus card? Why?
We have to get the money out of the election process. That means an amendment to overturn Citizens United!
Oh, okay.
Corporations have the right to free speech.
Give me my bus card!
Oh, no. Money is not speech!
The Supreme Court said it was.
Jim, you are so right about that guy next door. Turns out he is a CEO and he is going to give me $15,000 a month to finance my campaign.
What'd I tell you? Stick by your principles, things are looking up.
Please, I need my bus card.
Give her her bus card.
A CEO in this neighborhood? The neighbor on the left is a security guard. And the neighbor on the right is